Sommigen in het Nederlands. Dus vandaar. Dan gaan we beginnen. So welcome everyone to and thanks for getting out in this cold weather to this manifestation in front of the Office of Sustainability of the multinational Ahold, better known as Albert Heijn in the Netherlands. Today we're going to hand over 26,000 signatures against a new greenwash label for soy produced by the Roundtable on Responsible Soy, RTRS. These signatures have been sent with a message to many supermarket chains across Europe, amongst others to Ahold, saying please stop misleading the public with such a greenwash label. What do we have on offer for you today? We don't have any cheap sausages or things like that that Ahold specializes in, but we have some interesting speakers. We have hot coffee and tea and a good responsible sandwich. And we have some live music in between and at the end. The speakers will include Camille Donici of Vian, Netherlands. Also Luc van Krunkelsven of the Belgian organization Wervel. We'll have a phone conversation with Jorge Galeano of the Paraguayan movement of peasants. Guus Geurts on behalf of the platform Earth Farmers and Consumers, platform ABC from the Netherlands. And Maaike Vierstra of AC Europe. So why did so many people sign this petition against greenwash soy? Ahold was one of the companies that was targeted and pretends to be a sustainable company. It's a member of the Roundtable on Sustainable Soy, and as everyone knows, the large-scale production of soy in monocultures is causing a lot of environmental degradation and poverty in the areas where it's produced in South America. It has led to a lot of land conflicts in Argentina, Paraguay and Brazil. Soy is sprayed with glyphosate or Roundup and many other pesticides, including paraquat, atrazine, 2.4-D and many more. On the other hand, at this side of the ocean, soy is being used for intensive livestock production or factory farms to produce cheap meat, also for the export, causing massive pollution and also the extinction of small sustainable farms in Europe. The RTRS says to make the soy production more responsible, but nothing could be further from the truth. They have negotiated for 6 years in luxury hotels around South America, and in these negotiations some NGOs like WWF, the World Wildlife Fund, have negotiated some criteria with companies like Cargill, Ahold and Monsanto. But these criteria means that actually no change is needed on behalf of the soy producers. You can basically continue business as usual. Nevertheless, it will be labeled with a greenwash label by the Roundtable, supported by the Panda logo. So the first soy is now being certified. It's going to be imported this spring. And we have seen the first audit reports from the certifiers, and we can basically conclude that they confirm what we've already been saying, and that was also confirmed in our conversation just now with Ahold, that actually no change is needed in the soy production in order to get this label. So it's really a hollow promise, it's really an empty shell. To give an example, the Roundtable just allows you to keep deforesting and still call your soy responsible. You're only not allowed to maybe deforest some very precious nature areas, but you can still do that for your uncertified production. So any soy producer can just sell certified soy and uncertified soy at the same time. There's nothing to prevent them from doing that. So in fact, you're not helping anything. The Roundtable says that they will produce maps where you can responsibly expand your soy plantations and where you cannot. So did mean that WWF is actually deciding where lands can be turned into toxic soy plantations and where not, and what gives them the legitimacy to do so. Secondly, the pesticides. There are no concrete criteria in the RTRS that say that you have to reduce the pesticides. And we see in the audit reports as well that actually no soy farmer actually has a plan to reduce the use of pesticides. It even says that you can spray over inhabited areas, so where people live, only if you spray within 500 meters. If you could please tell the inhabitants beforehand so that they can leave their houses. Can you imagine that something like that would happen in Europe? That somebody will do aerial spraying with glyphosate on top of your house and just tells you 20 minutes beforehand, can you please leave your house because we're going to spray you with glyphosate. This is highly scandalous, I would say, and it's even much weaker and much more damaging than what most laws say. For example, in Paraguay, aerial spraying is already forbidden, and in most of Europe as well. So according to the RTRS, it's even acceptable to spray very near inhabited houses and even on top of it. So since the beginning of the RTRS, many organizations have protested, not only by signing declarations, but also by taking action in front of the conferences. And this has had as a result that companies like Ahold are not intending to put this label on their packaging, because they know that they will not convince the consumers that this is actually a better product than any other one. They will, however, use it in their political propaganda, like in their sustainability report, saying, you know, we are doing something, we are part of this process, and therefore we can continue to sell unsustainable meat products. They also said in their response by letter, there's no alternative available, but as we will hear later from Wervel, there are many alternatives, and the food and feed companies around Europe are simply not willing to really invest in it. The Dutch government is financing this project with millions of euros. It's giving this millions of euros to Dutch NGOs, so environmental and development organizations, including WWF, but also Solidaridad, also Both Ends, and now even Stichting Natuur en Milieu has become a member of the RTRS. Even though they know and they already admitted that these criteria do not give any proof of any step in the direction of more sustainability or more support for people living around the soya fields. You would ask, is this normal? No, this is not normal, because the Netherlands is in a pretty unique situation in that respect. In no other country is there support from these kind of organizations nearly than in the Netherlands. The Belgian organizations have been complaining to their Dutch colleagues about it. The German organizations have written to WWF, like, please stop with this kind of greenwash project. Solidaridad, for example, got 29 million euros for all these kinds of sustainable projects. They get this from the what they call the Initiative Sustainable Trade, IDH. And why are these organizations not doing other projects in South America, like actually supporting farmers that resist the expansion of the soy fields? You don't see them there, or support them in the fight against the pesticide spraying. All they do is negotiate here with multinationals on some greenwash label, and you can really wonder what the benefit is of that. And to make things worse, the RTRS is now also certifying soy biodiesel, so soya oil, to run European cars as a supposedly a climate measure. So we want to tell Ahold, and not only Ahold, but also the wider public, that this is this kind of green capitalism, greenwashing, fake solutions for climate change. Nobody believes it anymore, and we should get rid of it.
Yeah!
I would like to hand over the word to Camille of FIAM.